Disclaimer, no investment advice provided. This is for entertainment and educational purposes only. Please read the disclaimer in your own time. Thank you. Guys, Swayzers here. We are going to remake this video tutorial about how to identify a downtrend, what is it, and what we should not do within downtrends, and how downtrends move. It's going to be similar, obviously, to the previous updated video about uptrends, but this is going to be downtrends. Very, 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 very important, guys, right? Very, very important indeed. 95%, right, and these are true statistics, 95%, and I'm sure you've heard this before, guys, right, of retail investors, right, consistently lose to the markets, to the market makers, right? Why do such a large percentage of retail investors lose? Well, it's lack of knowledge, it's lack of awareness, it's buying into rampers, retweeters, it's trading and taking decisions using emotion, things that they think they know, sure things. You know, the army of rampers, retweeters, news articles, and the army, or the armies that fight against us in this war. And it is a war, right? It's a war for your resources. Never, ever forget that, guys, right? The markets are not random, right? There's nothing random about any move you see in the markets. The markets are not random. The market is a cold, soulless, calculating machine created by geniuses with vast amounts of time and vast amounts of energy and vast amounts of resources, who are actively working against us and you with the sole ambition and the sole purpose of taking money out of your bank account and putting it into their own. Full stop. That's it. End of. That is the MO. That is the agenda. And that is what they are highly successful at doing. And that is what they have been doing for many, many, many years. Right? It's a war of attrition. It's a war of misinformation. It is a war of deception. Right? And if you do not believe what I'm saying, you are deluded, right? And your worldview and your belief system is incorrect, because I can prove it on the charts. So this is how serious it gets, right? The question we should all be asking ourselves is, do we want to create and learn? Well, the question, sorry, is, do we want to learn a system that can give us a fighting chance against the market makers? And of course, it's a loaded question. Of course, the answer is, of course, it is yes. This is why you're here. This is why you've joined. This is why you've paid me your hard-earned money to come into this community, become a member of this community, and learn this system of technical analysis. So, you know what? Give yourselves a pat on the back, guys. Congratulations for coming this far, right? Because believe me, I'm very, very serious about this. Yeah, we have a laugh and a joke. We have a sense of humor and all the rest of it. But at the end of the day, guys, right, we do not have their resources, right? We cannot win them in a fair fight, right? Because the market makers hold all the keys, right, to wealth, resources. They have the media in their pockets. In many cases, they own the media. They have an army of retweeters and rampers on social media actively working against us and you. So because it is a calculated system, we need to employ our own calculated system, right, which is an antidote, an anti-script against the matrix, the matrix and the system that they use. Now, sorry for going on a little bit, but I think it's extremely important that we know what we're up against. Now, the reason why this video tutorial is so important, guys, is because the biggest mistake that the vast majority of people that lose to the market makers, the biggest mistake they do, guys, is they'll buy in a downtrend, right? They'll go long in a downtrend. Now, if you remember from the video tutorial about identifying uptrends, downtrends are the opposite. Now, what we're looking at is hurricane on the daily chart, every candle today. This is the macro market state, the super macro. And I think anyone that's versed with the alternative investment market will know all about hurricane, right? The tragedy that is hurricane. But guys, there's nothing random about what's happened with hurricane. This is, in my opinion, premeditated legal robbery. We look at the macro, right? We've got the head and shoulders reversal pattern, left shoulder, head, right shoulder. We'll learn about them as we go along. Don't concern yourself too much about these patterns yet. You will learn about these patterns and how to identify these. So look, right, so if you would have been in hurricane, right, mid-September 2019, say you got in, right, the share price was 49.7 pence then, right? Look what happened. Just huge sell-off, aggressive sell-off, downtrend. Huge downtrend. It happened rapidly, right? Very rapidly. You see, in fact, if we zoom into the action, right, we see we had a market gap. Market gaps are designed to take you out so fast, you wouldn't even know what's hit you. So when the deception before this, well, the theft had already occurred because it was already downtrending, but it was more of a consolidation range at that stage. But do you see this deceptive candle? This last candle, right? See this last candle? Look at that. It's like a couple of solid buying candles, right? The last few candles, and then it gapped. That's when this calculated robbery ensued. So what we're going to do, we're going to learn how to integrate methodologies together, right? So, and combine them so we can see the bigger picture. So we've got a head and shoulders reversal, but what is a downtrend? Well, a downtrend, guys, is the opposite, obviously, to an uptrend. The market is selling off, right? Price is making lower lows, right? Lower lows, selling off. Look, there's another gap there just to make sure that, boom, everyone's out of the game. Right, so it's selling off, right? So if you imagine a fast flowing river and the river is flowing from left to right, okay, and you imagine that this is flowing from left to right, why in a million years would you try to enter that environment, right, and try and swim, right, against the current? Why would you do it? It would be suicide. It doesn't matter how athletic or how strong you are, right, if you imagine that this is a river, right, this is a fast flowing river flowing from left to right, okay, you're the little cursor key, you jump in, ooh, look at you, trying to swim against this, no chance. You're going to get swept away, you're going to become exhausted, and then you're going to perish, right? The water's very cold, it's chilly, it's extremely powerful, you're losing your, the will to live, right? That's the analogy that I will use, right? This is why 95% of retail investors get wiped out and took out of the game. Guys, there is the 90-90-90 rule. And these are true statistics, right? 90% of retail investors lose 90% of their accounts within 90 days. You'll see it all over Twitter, right? So if you, for example, we're talking about hurricane as an example, right? Right about these dates, right? You go back on Twitter, right? And you'll see everyone saying bye, bye, bye. Go over to LSE forums. All these accounts will be saying, yay, there's good news coming. There's an RNS coming. The good news, right? There's light at the end of the tunnel. Hurricane's going to go to the moon. And you're being influenced subliminally, right? And consciously and subconsciously, you're being programmed, right, to buy this stock at these levels. And then the market makers come along, boom, right? They get rich, you get poor. Simple as that. This is a microcosm of the macrocosm of what are the markets, right? And how many times have you guys been caught out? We've all been caught out. So what we need to do, right, when we approach the markets from technical analysis perspective, guys, right, is identify what is going on, right? What is the flow of the market? Well, with Hurricane on this chart, we can see, guys, that it's a downtrend, right? There's many ways to identify a downtrend, right? We look at the macro first. We look at the daily chart. We can see that price is making lower lows, right? There's some very, very thick, red, solid, bearish candles. Now, what you'll also see as well with the EMAs, and what we use with Swayze's Charts Discord and this system of TA, we use four EMAs. We use the 21, the 50, the 100, and the 200. You will see, guys, right, that price is well below the EMAs every time. And if we just zoom in to a little bit more of local action, every time that price tried to touch the 21, sold off. Look, price tried to touch again. If we just zoom in to this downtrend here on the macro, right? Look, price came, tried to touch, sold off. Tried to touch, sold off, right? Now, look, there are up moves within a downtrend, right? But we do not buy this market, right? It is insanity, right? Why would you want to buy a downtrend? Even though there may be pullbacks within it, you might get away with it now and again. But guys, right, if you are going long in a downtrend, you are severely, severely reducing your chances of success. So what we do is we identify market states on the daily chart and on the 4-hour chart, right, and we give ourselves the best opportunity, right? So as far as I'm concerned, right, we've got four market states. This is my opinion, right? And I've said this many times before. We're learning about the market states. So we've got four market states, four personalities, right, of the market. So we've got a ranging market state, which we'll learn about. That's when price is just going up and down. The EMAs are typically within the middle of price action. And they are created on purpose to take you out of the game as well. That's a whole different tutorial, which we will redo. A new tutorial on the ranging market states. Then the second market state is an uptrend. We've covered what an uptrend is, right? To give ourselves the best chances of winning, right, in this game. Third market state is a downtrend. This is what we're looking at now. Fourth market state is a consolidation. Consolidation is like a range, but within a tighter price bandwidth. So look, guys, right, we've got a downtrend, right, with Hurricane, right? Look at just every time that price tries to interact or get above this 21. He got above the 21 here, got knocked back by the 50, right? Got above the 21, knocked back down by the 50, right? And then price is simply underneath this 21, every time it times a touch, down, selling off like a good un, right? Now, we've got a pullback, as we can see. But guys, right, when we zoom in and we're learning about channel drawing as well, okay, drawing this channel of this downtrend, right, when we zoom in, we can see that this is a pullback, right? Now, in certain situations, yeah, pull, but you can trade a pullback, right? But it is my advice, right, of all the hundreds and hundreds of tickers and stocks in the markets and in the air market, right, why would you want to risk trading a macro downtrend when there's so many uptrends that we can identify, right? Why would you want to do it? This is what I always say, right, guys, right? With these individual components of technical analysis that we are learning, they're individual components, right? I'm not going to go into them now because I don't want to confuse, but we learn individual skill sets. And then what we do is we marry them together, right, in harmony. Okay, it's a language. We are prepping the canvas, right, like I've said in the first ever video tutorial. of identifying macro market state, we're prepping the canvas, and then we are applying these individual components. For example, identifying trends. And every time that we do something which enables us to read the language of the charts, right, we are giving ourselves a distinct advantage over 95% of retail investors. Now, how this game works, guys, how this game works is there has to be losers and winners, right? So when we are entering the market, right, we are buying the stock off other investors, correct? That is what we are doing. So we have to be better than 95% of the retail investors out there, because we are buying their stock, so they're selling while we're buying, right? Or they're buying while we're selling. That's how it works. That's what a market is. So we use these different methodologies to give ourselves a higher percentage chance of being successful than your average typical retail investor. Now, let's have a look at CNA. Because these downtrends, guys, right? These downtrends, right? And make no mistake about it, they can go on for years and years and years. Now, there's a couple of different ways of trading the markets. Not financial advice, of course. This is in line with the system of technical analysis. There's different ways. You can use margin accounts, or you can buy the shares. So, okay, let's look at CNA on the daily chart as an example, right? So this is the macro market state, right? Every single candle is a day of trading. Centrica PLC on the daily chart, right? I'm going to show you something, guys. This is why this is a serious, serious business. Look at this, guys, right? Look at this uptrend, met an all-time high, okay? Sold off, right? So mid to late September, right, you would have been in with Centrica at 395.38, right? That was 2013. I was still in Mexico in 2013, right? Living in the Caribbean, right? So that's when we got into it. That's when, okay, this is a hypothetical scenario. So that's when you would have got into it, right? You bought 2013. Guys, CNA subsequently sold off in a downtrend for 7 years, guys. Nearly 8 years it's been in a downtrend. Slowly bleeding out all the money out of this company, right? Going into the pockets of the sellers, the market makers, the dealers and the elites. Since 2013, guys. What are you going to do, right? What are you going to do? This is the question, right? This is the question, right? It's not a rhetorical question. This is the question. I'm asking you guys a question, right? You bought at 395 in 2013. It just sells off. What are you going to do? Well, the market makers want you to sell your position. If you was a margin trader, you would have been out of the game years ago. You're gone, right? You stop loss activated, right? You pay your dues, you're out. The market makers have got your money. The brokers and the market makers split the deal, right? They've got your money. But what are you going to do if you bought £50,000 in sterling of Centrica stock at the all-time high because you thought it was going to go to the moon because the market makers create this lovely little uptrend, okay? And then you're in. You're in. Same thing, Bitcoin. You're in at the top. It's going to the moon. Cryptocurrency, Ethereum, Tronix, TRX. You're in. You think it's going to the moon. Then it starts selling off. What are you going to do? You got two choices, right? You can either grin and bear it and watch your 50,000 quid shrink to 5 grand, if you're lucky, or you can get out with a loss, right? Capital protection and risk aversion. We'll be looking at that down the line in more tutorials, but look, right? We would not be in this move, guys, right? We wouldn't be in this move because we would have identified this downtrend, right? We would have identified that this was a downtrend and we wouldn't be in it. we would take ourselves out of the equation, right? You can't lose the game, right, if you're not playing, can you? So this is why we don't play this game, right? We don't go long. We don't buy when the market is selling off like this. It's insanity. It's a fast-flowing river. It's a current that we cannot possibly ever hope to win against. Excuse me. Look at this downtrend. Indicative of downtrends, and I have to use that word because I love it so much. Look at the EMAs. Typically, right above, right on top, in various different degrees. You'll have the 21, and then you've got the 50, then you've got the 100, and then you've got the big daddy 200, right? Every time price has tried to break on top of these EMAs, it's beaten back down, making lower lows, trending down, EMAs all sat on top. We've got this pullback that we are tracking at the minute with CNA. This is a pullback. Yes, you can trade pullbacks, but you've got to be so, so careful because the macro market state is still a downtrend. It's basically like you're going down the rapids in a canoe, right? And then, you know, you're trying to get out of the rapids because it's really dangerous. You can't control the boat, right, the canoe. But then you come into like a little gentle patch. It's like a bend in the river, if you like. Do you know what I mean? There's some rocks which have like dissipated the force of the river. And it gives you a little bit of a fighting chance, right, to try and get out. Right, that's what pullback is. That's what a pullback is. Excuse me. Frog in my throat tonight. So that's what a pullback is, right? But you've got to be careful. So price is now testing this historical 7-year downtrend. Now, when you guys learn how to effectively draw channels, right, and the other methodologies that we use and the other components, it'll bring it all together, right, and you'll be able to understand what you're looking at. But what we're talking about in this tutorial, guys, is downtrends, right? You don't buy the market in a downtrend. Avoid them like the plague, right? In my opinion, not financial advice. This is for entertainment and educational purposes only. Learning this system of technical analysis, right? So we looked at Hurricane, we've looked at CNA, right? Okay, a downtrend is one market state where you do not want to start thinking about buying. The only time you're thinking about getting in is possibly playing a pullback for a short time to move, or price is now testing this 7-year downtrend, right? And if it breaks it with conviction, we'll then look for high quality areas of the charts, because then it'll be doing something else. It won't be downtrending. But then we've got to figure out what it is going to do. Is it going to trend up? Is it going to consolidate? Is it going to range? What's it going to do? It's going to be doing something. The market is always up to something, right? Downtrends, price is making lower lows. There's a lot of sell-off candles. Every time price comes to these levels of resistance, these trend lines, right, sell-off, right? Every time price tries to break above, well, let me just zoom into this action, then you can see. Every time that price tries to break above the EMAs, specifically 21 and 50, it's beaten back. It's beaten back. If it gets through the 21, it's got the 50 to contend with. If it gets through the 50, it's got the 100. And then if it gets through the 100, it's got the 200. It's going to get its ass whooped every single time in a strong downtrend. This is a danger zone. We do not buy downtrends. Price is making lower lows. There's loads of red selling candles. The EMAs are fixed above, right? Price, every time price tries to break out of the EMAs, it gets beaten back. They're like force fields pushing price down, okay? Why would you, even in a million years, think about buying this market? Forget about rampers. Forget about retweeters. Forget about disinformation. Forget about deception. The market makers are not your friend. They are cold calculated. It is a cold calculated system that is designed with the sole purpose of removing your resources and your money from your wallet, from your bank account, and put it in theirs. These people, these individuals who control this system have been at it for nearly 100 years with the markets, right? Right, and we are learning a system to combat that, right? We do not want to, if this was a game of chess, right? If CNA on the daily was a game of chess, guys, right? Right, why would you even think about playing, right? You're basically playing against some grandmaster and you're a rookie chess player that's been playing for a couple of weeks. You're going to get your ass handed to you on a silver plate. You're going to get your ass whooped, right? We identify market stakes. We identify downtrends. They're making lower lows. Price is selling off like a good one. Right? I've seen downtrends going on for 15 years. Right? The market makers understand how to elicit an emotional response out of a human being. They have studied us very, very deeply. They know what makes us tick. Right? And it's that losing the will to live. We've all been locked into a position, haven't we? Where we bought with anticipation, right, and excitement. My favourite ramper and retweeter said that I should buy this stock because it's going to the moon. Wahey! Pack your bags, Gladys. We're going to Tenerife. The only thing where you're going, mate, right, is the dole queue, because you've put your mortgage on the line to buy a stock that you thought were going to the moon, right? You've leveraged too much. You've risked what you can't afford to lose. And now you're getting taught a lesson that millions of retail investors, unfortunately, have had to go through. Do they learn from these lessons? Most of them don't. Most of them don't, because they have a cognitive dissonance. They're existing in... they believe worldviews, right, as truth, and they've been brainwashed that much by the elite systems that rule over us, the world financial market specifically, right? They believe the lie so much that they could not possibly accept that they've been outplayed, outmoved, manipulated. The sole purpose is taking the money. And, you know, I feel sorry for these people. You know, I was one of them, you know what I mean, before I woke up, before I got the red pill. But I had to go through hell, right, to figure it all out. Luckily, thank God, literally thank God, I came out the other side. Now, guys, right, this is one of the most important lessons you're ever going to have in technical analysis, especially learning this system, is how to identify a downtrend, right, because it's so important we don't go against the flow, right? Lower lows, EMAs above, price cannot get past. And when it's coming to these areas here on these channels, right, of these macro trends, look at that. Every time it's touched for 7-8 years, this downtrend here, and you'll learn how to draw channels, don't worry. You'll learn how to draw them. You'll learn how to identify it. Every time price touches these key levels, sell off, sell off, sell off. Now we've got this 7-8 year downtrend, whatever it is, right, approaching the macro downtrend, upper trend line, right? It's approaching it. Let's see what happens. Will CNA finally defeat this downtrend? Have the market makers taken enough? Have they got their fill? They have an insatiable appetite. Have they got their fill, right? 395.46 or whatever it was in 2013. And we're now in 2021. And it's at 46.42. Right, welcome to the markets, guys, right? You don't need me to keep going on like a broken record. I'm going to finish this video tutorial very shortly, okay? Now, what I will say is downtrends, right? What we're typically doing, guys, right, is we're looking on the daily and the 4-hour chart, right, for this strategy and this system of TA that we use, right? So we typically look on the 4-hour, and we typically look on the daily chart. You're going to learn about head and shoulders reversal patterns, and you're going to learn as well that the market moves within channels, right? But don't worry about that at the minute. I mean, look at this, is a downtrend in local action all on its own. You see it? right? Price is making lower lows, right? This is the 4 hour chart, okay? Look at the gaps to the low, look at the sell-off. The market makers are taking everything out of the pot. Everything out of the pot. I mean, look at the angle of descent. Look at the short sells involved. The squeezes, should I say. You would not get involved, even in pullbacks. It's very, very risky. Very, very risky. Because even if you got involved in this pullback here, look at the way it came up, encountered this trend line, got close to it, boom! Look at the sell-off. Right? Identifying downtrends, what are they? Why we don't trade them, why we don't buy the market, why we don't swim against the tide. I'm going to end this video now. Guys, thank you for being here, right? You're on a journey of discovery, right? We're all learning together, okay? If you have any questions about this tutorial, no problem. Send me a DM. Ask the questions in the uptrend room. And it's an absolute pleasure that you're here. Let's get better. Let's improve. Let's progress. Let's learn a few tricks. Let's learn a few tactics and how to combat the market makers, the dealers, the elites. Because I've proven, right, many of the students now are getting fantastic results. The portfolios are turning around. They're going from red to blue. We're seeing opportunities up and down the markets. But what I'm saying, guys, right, if you've got 1,000 stocks to choose from, why in the million years would you want to get involved in buying downtrends? Okay. And what I want you to do is practice in back testing, practice identifying market states, looking for the indicators of what a downtrend is from this video tutorial, price making lower lows, touching EMAs, selling off, how it's reacting in the macro channel, and then as you go on and start developing this skill set, you'll learn how to draw consolidation zones, triangles, channels within channels, and all the good stuff. You're going to bring all these methodologies together to make you an elite chartist down the road. All right, guys, I'll love you and leave you. I'll upload this now to replace the older one. I wanted to make a more comprehensive and impactful video tutorial. The original one was 5 minutes long, so I think we've done a bit of a better job with this one. All right, you lovely people, I'll see you knocking around in the uptrend room. I'm out of here.